Hello, you guys. My name is Ryn, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I have for you another speed build, and oh my gosh, I have not recorded in a while. I've recorded a lot before I went on vacation, and I went on vacation throughout, a good portion of last week, and I did a ton of recording so that you guys had let's plays and speed builds, and I did the starter house week, and in fact, one of those homes got a Maxis like on the Sims 4 gallery, so I was really excited about that and felt like a lot of my hard work with recording early really paid off. So that was really, really exciting. If you would like to know, the little blue starter house actually got the Maxis like. So that made me feel good. And yeah, it was really unexpected. So I was really excited about that. But I worked really hard to get all those up, and then I went on vacation. I went back up to New York City, and halfway through my vacation, I started not feeling so well, but I think the adrenaline and the excitement of being in the city and again helped me to just sort of push through any kind of illness, sickness I was feeling. But then when I got home, did that sickness wreak havoc on my system. I needed sleep. I needed to just recuperate. And I had only had videos planned for that week up until last Tuesday. And because my husband and I got back on Monday. And then I figured, I don't want to be too pressed for time on Tuesday for a video. So I just had stuff ready through then. But I was coughing a lot. I was really nasally sneezing. So I could not record anything for Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday because I just sounded like a wreck. So I didn't want to subject you guys to that. And also my energy was probably understandably very low, just trying to recuperate and everything. So I took some time off, and I'm certainly not back to 100%, but I really, you know, the last couple months, I started my channel back in March. I really wanted to make sure that I was uploading consistently. And it started out with videos about 3 days a week, and then I switched it eventually up to 5 days a week. And that's because I enjoy it, and it's because I want to get a lot of content out because I know how I like to watch other people's channels. I love when they can put out as much as possible. So I've been really pushing myself with this channel, and I hope it's paying off for you guys. It's paying off from my point of view, and I do really like it. I just didn't want to push myself through being sick and having you guys hear that and not being excited about what I'm building. So I just knew that I needed to take a break. I needed to rest and kind of recoup for a while. So I hope you guys understand why there were no videos last Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. But to make up for that, this is up on a Saturday, which is very unusual for me. I normally do not post on the weekends. So I hope that you like this. And while I was recouping, the Parenthood pack came out, which was really exciting. To be honest with you guys, I wasn't sure how I felt about the Parenthood pack. I think because I'm not a family player. I don't often play with sim families, if that makes any sense. You know, I don't toy around with children, teenagers, toddlers, babies. Just in my normal gameplay, I don't. And it's not that I don't like them. I just tend to kind of I like to focus usually on one sim at a time, although I'm getting a lot better at that with my Let's Plays. And I'm actually enjoying playing with more sims because I realize you don't have to focus on all of them at once. So I am changing my mind. But usually I just like to play with single sims and kind of work on them solely. So I wasn't really excited about the pack. And also, I'm starting to realize that, golly, what did it come with? The game pack that came with the clubs. Like, I'm kind of realizing that EA, Maxis, the Sims people, what they bring with every pack, it's hard to explain through the trailers that they have, because it's very much a hands-on experience. I didn't understand the clubs at first. I don't think any of us did. And once we got our hands on it, it was like, oh, okay, this is pretty cool. I think the same can be said for the Parenthood pack. From the trailer, you just kind of get, okay, like, you're parenting and there's some new objects to interact with. So what? But once you get the pack and you start playing around with it, it's really fun. And honestly, too, I was not expecting this. They had a lot of great objects, a lot of good build buy stuff. The cast, the create a sim items, some are really cool, some are and there isn't that much. But when it comes to furniture, objects, decor, I feel like they really treated us to something really nice. And I am really excited about that the most. But I'm also excited to really dive more into the gameplay of Parenthood, because I have toyed around with it on my own. And of course, it'll be really interesting to see how that plays into the 100 Baby Challenge, which I hope to record more of those episodes this weekend. And without sounding like a frog. I feel like I sound like a frog right now because I just sound different to me. So if that's translating over, I apologize. If it's annoying, sorry. I can't help it right now. I'm trying my best not to cough either. So far, so good in this video. But anyway, all of that said, I wanted to do a build. I honestly just wanted to do a build that just made me feel good in the sense of just exploring the game some more. And honestly, too, I just wanted to play around with the new objects from Parenthood Pack. Like I said, I really like them. And just start injecting them into my designs. And so that's what I did with this build. Oh, this part's really funny. I was watching Million Dollar Listing LA, and in one of the homes, they had a nectar bar underneath the staircase. And I was like, that is a genius place to put a well, not nectar bar, but a nectar storage area. So that made an appearance in this build. But anyway, I just wanted to do a build that was just, it didn't really have a point other than it's my interpretation of a modern suburban family home. And where a lot of the interior was more sophisticated, a little more modern. The exterior, is obviously extremely modern. And I always wanted to play around with the kind of cubic shape of a home, as well as putting those panels on the outside of the house, those wooden panels and slats, I guess you could say, and just kind of dinking around with that. I wanted to just sort of not have a point and just, the only point being that this would be a family suburban home, and then just see where that took me with all of the new Parenthood stuff. Long story short, there you go. So I had a great time doing this one. It did take a little longer than I thought because I was really trying to find and use a lot of the Parenthood pack items as best as I could without like forcing it. There's always going to be opportunities to use them again, and I certainly will use them in future builds because the items are so good. So one of my favorite objects is actually the mason jar lighting that you'll see in the master bedroom and the master bath in this house. It's just so darn cute. So I really like that. And this wallpaper with the trees, I was really inspired by that as well. I wanted to put that in this build, and it just sort of fit in with this sort of natural modern look that the house just sort of turned into. So I really enjoyed this build. I don't know if it's 100% done for me, design wise. There were just some kind of design tricks that I don't know if I'm 100% happy with, but overall I'm pleased. And this does feel like a family home that suits a family that is sophisticated and yet a little quirky, I guess. So I think all in all, it came out really well. And, well, I'm hoping to start kind of exploring some more. Well, I don't know. I'm sort of thinking of restructuring some of my speed builds. I'm actually thinking of doing some restructuring with a lot of my videos. I just want to do something new. Even if it's not a new concept, I want to do something new for myself. I want to jazz up the videos and just make them a lot more entertaining for you guys and just more fun. You know, I enjoy just talking over the speed builds, but I wonder if there's something else I could do to really make this a bit more entertaining other than just hearing me talk over a speed run here. But I have a lot in my mind. I've had time to kind of think about the creative direction of this channel. So I'm hoping to start bringing you guys some new stuff in the near future. So don't expect any big changes anytime really soon, but really in the future here, we'll get there. But here's the finished modern suburban home. And I love that shot. I love that wood texture and the panels on the sides really just give it some character, you know. I really love how that turned out, and I'm definitely going to use those wood panels in some future builds because they look great. And here's the backyard. I wanted it to stay serene, minimalistic, and really just kind of pair well with the exterior. That pool looks so inviting, and with summer arriving, I would really love to go for a dip. Here's the side of the house. Oh, and initially, I forgot to mention, the house was facing the other way towards the other sidewalk, but on the thumbnail for the gallery, it was turned sideways, so I just flipped it to this side so y'all could see it. Here's the entry, and there's that nectar storage underneath the stairwell. Here's the kitchen with some copper mats, which, y'all, I love those mats. I think they're technically, I don't even know, grates or something, but I love them. They're so pretty. The color just was perfect. It was warm and vibrant enough for the space. And look at all that new kitchen stuff from the Parenthood pack. I love it. Here's just a cozy little corner near the dining room, which is an open concept from the kitchen. There's a little dining room right there and a door going to the outside space. Here's a little kid's corner, and behind him is the door to the bathroom, which we see right here. This bathroom can be accessed from both inside and outside. That's what those two doors are for. So when they come in from the pool, it's really quick to get in there. Here's a shot from the bathroom door looking into the living room. And here's the living room and kind of a chess recreational area. There's a guitar there and such. So for Sims to improve some skills and such. I say such a lot. But anyway, there's the door behind him goes out to the pool, and the living room looks really nice. I really like the chair he's sitting in. That's also new with the Parenthood pack. Here we're going up the stairs, and we will see the landing, which looks really cool. I like how all the colors came out together. Here's a little study area also on the landing for the kids. I made this so that children/teenagers could live in this house. And here's bedroom number one. It's for a girl. And a lot of this is from that Parenthood pack. Here is our teenager. She's just checking herself out in that mirror, kind of doing her own teenage thing in her room away from everybody else, of course. I love this corner. There's a journal on that table there, too. Everything looks so cute together. Here's the boys' room, and hey, there's a basketball hoop. Why is that? We'll see in a second. But again, a lot of this is from the Parenthood pack, and it is awesome. I love it. I really wanted this to just be, I don't know, just a fun... Oh, there's the basketball hoop. Yes. Yes, your Sims can play basketball in this room. It is awesome. Boy's bedroom of dreams, whatever. A girl can be in there too. Any Sim would love that. Here's the bathroom that the kids share. And I really love black, white, and brown together. It's one of my favorite color combinations, and another angle here of the bathroom. Here's the master bedroom with those mason jar lights. I don't really know why I put two lights underneath the mason jar lights, but hey, what are you going to do? I don't mind the look. I like it. Here are the dressers, a his and hers dresser set, a little nook where some magazines are placed in a holder, and then we're going into the master bath, which is a blue and white and kind of a gray theme. Here is the his and hers sinks. Here are the his and hers sinks, and the shower and a little laundry hamper. I think the lights in here are pretty intense, but it's okay. Here's a mason jar over the tub, which just looks really inviting. We're finally back outside looking at the very inviting pool. Just a fun little shot from the pool looking at the rest of the deck. And here is a shot of the deck and, of course, a barbecue for those lovely summer evenings. A jungle gym. Well, monkey bars, actually, for the kids. And I love this shot, too. It's just all very clean, and I like that. And here's the last shot of the house, you guys. And I think we're going to end with the kids. Yes, we are. And guys, thank you so much for watching. Thanks for bearing with me as I get through this illness. But you guys, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like my channel, please, please subscribe. You guys, you can find me on Twitch, Twitter, and the Sims 4 Gallery, all RynAsInWin. And guys, this will also be available on the Sims 4 Gallery. Just look me up, RynAsInWin, hashtag or user ID. You guys, the internet is a busy place, and I am honored that you choose to spend your time with me. Thank you so much. I love you guys, and I will see you next time. Bye.